In the name of Allah, who is the most beneficent and most merciful. Hi guys, how are you? I hope you will be fine. Today I want to reply you briefly review the point in the economic ideas and the development of economic thinking in the ancient times. So, howsoever recent the history of civilization may be, the development of the systematic body of the economic doctrines, it's always possible to discover the trend in the economic thinking, if not the scientific philosophy, in the chance observation and stray remarks of the ancient philosophers, which may contain in the sum doctrines developed by the economic thinkers of the modern era. All customs, institutions, laws, and the practice of their time did contain a certain measure of economic theory thought. It was never explicitly pronounced. Theories on economic matter, even if it may scarcity be term of economic theory, explicitly embraced in the writing of Greek philosophers, mostly in the form of incidental observation. The main thinkers of the time, whose ideas contained some economic content, had Plato, Aristotle, Xenophon, Epicurus. For the first record time, name is Plato. Plato, the world known Greek philosopher, was a teacher of Athenian Academy whose works, mainly in the form of philosopher dialogues, are related highly even the modern times. From the economic point of view, two of his books, The Republic and the Laws, are quite significant. It's in these works that we get some ideas about the economic of the overpopulation and underpopulation. His concept of the city-state is based on economic concentration and wants of human beings. Plato also discussed the concept of division of labor and wrote that all things were produced more plentifully and easily of better quality when one man did one thing which was natural to him. Plato's ideas about communication are quite interesting. In his view, there should be complete communism for Aristocrate or second mercantile name is Aristotle. Aristotle was the first analytical economist and a philosopher of extraordinary brilliance who contributed a great deal to ethics, economics and politics. Although he did not write any specific book on the economics, his observation about economics situation were quite scientific and precise. In his opinion, the state should be developed the highest qualities of man and should. The best part of the economic thought is his treatment of money. He said that money, apart from the being initially useful in the form of metal, comes to be introduced to commercial dealing. He described three functions of money: medium of exchange, standard of value, and the store of value. Aristotle favored private property because it provided incentive to work and was sure of further development. The third mercantile name is Xenophon. Xenophon was a renowned Greek philosopher whose contributions to economic literature were similar. In his views, agriculture was superior to all other professions, and the property of all other vocations was directly linked up with the development of agriculture. According to him, agriculture was the giver of all things and was easy to learn and pleasant in the practice. Next to agriculture, he also laid emphasis on extractive industries, perhaps the most important of the idea which was really novel in those days was suggestion to companies should be organized on a joint stock basis. The fourth and last mercantile name is Epicurus. Epicurus gave an economic philosophy of the different types, which is in fact the highest form of individualism. He emphasizes the need for having very few wants and that people should be satisfied with a very few possessions. A person who is not satisfied with a few things could not enjoy the full life because it was not easy to acquire many things. Rather, he suggests that if any person by chance acquires many possessions, he should distribute them among his. He suggests that if any person by chance acquires many possessions, he should distribute them among his fellow people who read may be the greater than in his own. Thus, Epicurus was in the favor of equality among the people.
So, as a result, I discussed those personalities who did not work on the economic theories, but those ideas, those thinking, and those organizations are those points are relevant to the economic thoughts. These are called mercantiles. So, I request to all people who are listening, please share and like my videos and please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon. That's why you can receive my new videos. So keep remember in your face. We will meet in the next videos. Stay blessed and goodbye.
Press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.